Modeling a knob of switch in Autodesk Inventor 2013. Open a new standard inch part file. Create a new 2D sketch on the XY plane. Draw a circle of 1 3/4 inch diameter coincident with the auto projected part origin. Click Finish 2D Sketch command from the marking menu to exit the sketching mode. Activate the extrude command. It will automatically select the circle as profile. Enter the extrusion value 1 4 inches and click OK. Change the color of the model to flaked reflective beam. Save the file with the name knob of switch. Change the view of the model by using View Cube. Set the view as home view by clicking the toggle next to view cube. Start a new sketch on the top face of the model. Take the project of circular edge and Y axis. Convert this vertical line and circle into construction geometry. Draw an arc over the projected edge of the model with the help of Center Point Arc tool. Apply a coincident constraint between midpoint of arc and projected y-axis line. Give a linear dimension 1 4 inch between both the endpoints of the arc. In the same way, draw another center point arc as displayed. Apply a coincident constraint between midpoint of arc and y-axis. Give a linear dimension 1 by 2 inch between both the endpoints of the arc. Finish the sketch. Create a new work axis on the one end of the arc parallel to Z axis of the model. Create a new work point at the intersection of work axis 1 and bottom circular edge of the model. Create a new work plane by using 3-point work plane tool. Close the visibility of work point 1 and work plane 1. Start a new sketch on this work plane. Take the project of the model by using projected cut edges tool. Draw two vertical lines on both the endpoints of the top projected edge of the model. And apply dimension 1 inch on these two lines. Close the profile by using line tool. Convert the sketches into construction geometry which are presently not in use. Exit from the sketching environment. Create another work axis on the second end point of the arc parallel to Z axis of the model. Create another work point at the intersection of work axis 2 and bottom circular edge of the model. create a new work plane by using 3 points work plane tool. Start a new sketch on this work plane. Take the project of the model by using projected cut edges tool. Draw two vertical lines on both the end points of the top edge of the model. And apply dimension 1 inch on these two lines. Close the profile by using line tool. Convert the sketches into construction geometry, which are presently not in use. Exit from the sketching environment. Create another 3-point work plane on the top end points of these lines. Create a new sketch on this work plane. Take the project of both arcs on this work plane. Finish the sketch. Start the loft tool. First, select both the closed sketch profiles in the design window. Then select 4 arcs as rails. Click OK to create the loft feature. Create a new sketch on the top face of the model. take the project of top face of model by using project geometry tool. Create a new sketch profile with the help of offset tool. Affix offset distance 1/32 inch between the lines. Take the offset of upper and lower segment of arc. Affix offset distance 5/16 inch between the arcs. Snap the end points of arcs with the adjacent lines by using coincident constraint tool. Erase the extra lines and arcs with the help of trim tool. Finish the 2D sketch. Cut the enclosed area defined by sketch 6, 1/32 inch towards downward direction by using extrude command. Pick up the fillet tool. Select this circular edge of the top face. Enter the value 1/4 inch in the radius input box and click OK. Apply another fillet of value 1/8 inch on the opposite side of the previous circular edge. Rotate the model by using View Cube. Create a new sketch on the bottom face of the model. Take the project of bottom face of the model with the help of project geometry tool. Create a new circle with the help of offset tool. Affix offset distance 1/8 inch between these two circles. Finish the sketch. Cut the enclosed area defined by sketch 7, 3x16 inch towards downward direction by using extrude command. Create a new sketch on the inner circular face of the model. Draw a circle of diameter 5x8 inch and extrude this circle to 1x8 inch. Create a new sketch on the YZ plane of knob switch. Right click in the design window and select Slice Graphics command. Take the project of Z-axis of the model and outer vertical edge. Select both the vertical lines and change their color to white. Draw a horizontal line. Place dimension 1x4 inch between bottom edge of the model and horizontal line. Select both the vertical lines and convert them into construction geometry. Draw a vertical line of 1x32 inch length over the projected Z-axis of the model. Draw an arc coincident with these two points with the help of 3-point arc tool. Create another horizontal line and apply a tangent constraint between arc and this line. Activate the revolve tool from the right click context menu. It will automatically select the sketch profile. Click on this line to specify the axis of revolution and click on green check mark. A smooth oval face is created. Rotate the model on the back side. Create a new sketch on the blue circular face. Draw a circle of diameter 5 by 16 inch, coincident with the center point of the model. Finish the sketch. Create a new work plane 5 by 8 inch downward from the blue face. Create a new sketch on this new work plane. Draw a circle of diameter 3 by 16 inch, coincident with the center point. Finish the sketch. Pick up the loft tool. Select upper and lower circles in the design window. Click Cut option in the loft dialog box. Click OK to create the loft feature. Align the model in the desired position by using View Cube. Create a new sketch on the blue circular face. Take a project of inner circle and convert it to construction geometry. Draw a line of length 3 by 16 inch parallel to x-axis. Snap one end point of line on the circle with the help of coincident constraint tool. Draw an arc between both the end points of the line by using center point arc tool. Finish the 2D sketch. Create a new sketch on the YZ plane of the knob. Right click in the design window and select Slice Graphics command. Take the project of the model by using Projected Cut Edges tool. Select all the sketches and convert them into construction geometry. Draw a line of the length 3 by 16 inch along the slant edge of the taper hole. Activate the sweep tool from the right click context menu. It will automatically select sketch as profile and taper line as path for sweep. Click OK to create the sweep feature. Create a new sketch on the blue circular face. Take the project of the model by using Project Cut Edges command. Right click in the design window and select Slice Graphics command. Draw two vertical lines on the opposite quadrants of the circle. Extrude this enclosed profile by 1 by 32 inch. Create a new sketch once again on the blue circular face. Take the project of the model by using Project Cut Edges tool. Take take the project of y-axis of the model by using Project Geometry tool. Select all the sketches and convert them into construction geometry. Activate the Slice Graphics command. Draw a vertical line between point 1 and point 2. And convert this line into construction geometry. Create a rectangle of dimension 3/16 inch into 5/16 inch on the midpoint of the vertical line with the help of 3-point center rectangle tool. Finish the 2D sketch. Open the visibility of Workplane 4. Create a new sketch on this work plane. Click Visual Styles icon from the Appearance panel of the View tab. Select Wireframe option. Take the project of center point of the rectangle. Activate the Slice Graphics command. Draw a 3-point center rectangle of dimension 1/8 inch into 5/24 inch on this point. Finish the 2D sketch. Pick up the loft tool. Select upper and lower rectangles in the design window. Click Cut option in the loft dialog box. Click OK to create the loft feature. Create a new sketch on the blue selected face. Take project of the model by using Project Cut Edges tool. Take the project of y-axis of the model by using Project Geometry tool. Select all the sketches and convert them into construction geometry. Activate the slice graphics command. Draw a vertical line between point 1 and point 2. And convert this line into construction geometry. Create a square of side 1/4 inch. On the midpoint of the vertical line with the help of 3-point center rectangle tool. Finish the sketch. Create a new work plane 17/32 inch downward from the blue face with the help of offset from plane 2. Create a new sketch on this work plane. Click Visual Styles icon from the Appearance panel of the View tab. Select Wireframe option. Take the project of center point of the rectangle. Activate the slice graphics command. Draw a square of side 1/6 inch on this point by using 3-point center rectangle tool. Finish the 2D sketch. pick up the loft tool. Select upper and lower rectangles in the design window. Click cut option in the loft dialog box. Click OK to create the loft feature. Create a new work plane on point 1, which is parallel to the XY plane of the model. Create a new work plane tangent to blue face of the model and parallel to XZ plane with the help of tangent to surface and parallel to plane command. Create a new sketch on this work plane. Take the project of Z axis of the model and work plane 7. And convert them into construction geometry. Draw a circle of diameter 3 by 16 inch, whose center lies on the projected Z axis of the model. Apply a tangent constraint between circle and projected edge of work plane 7. Finish the 2D sketch. Activate the extrude command. It will automatically select the circle as profile. Select cut option to remove the material. In the extents drop down of extrude dialog box, select 2 option. Select XZ plane of the model to specify end of extrude feature. Click OK to create the feature. We invite all of you to visit our blog, where you may get similar screencast videos. Please keep watching our videos. Goodbye.